Good morning, one and all. So we had been studying reduction for the past few classes, and now also we shall proceed with reduction of a new category. We shall see reduction of hydrocarbons. So let's proceed with that. Now, as we all know that an increase in the hydrogen content or a decrease in oxygen content of an organic compound is what is known as reduction. It may also be said as removal of oxygen, addition of hydrogen, and gain of electrons. The addition of hydrogen to unsaturated systems in the presence of catalyst or addition of molecular hydrogen as a reduction on metal is what is known as catalytic hydrogenation, which we shall be studying. Mostly all the alkenes can be saturated at very high yield with the treatment of hydrogen and a metal catalyst. And the hydrogenation of alkenes is an exothermic reaction. Now, there is a point why there is a need of catalyst when only addition of hydrogen atoms occur across pi bonds. Now, the reduction of alkenes with molecular hydrogen, it does not occur at room temperature without a catalyst, but often it takes place at room temperature if we use a catalyst. Also, the catalyst is able to give a new direction to the reaction involving low free energy of activation. So this is why we generally use catalysts for hydrogenation, and especially that is catalytic hydrogenation. Now let us see the mechanism of catalytic reduction. So first, in step one, the hydrogen and the ethene molecule collide with the nickel catalyst surface. So here I am showing you the reaction of ethene with hydrogen in the presence of nickel. These catalysts may be platinum, palladium, or nickel. As you already know, this is not a new reaction for you. So in step one, hydrogen and ethene molecules collide with the nickel catalyst surface. In step two, both the reactant molecules become physically adsorbed on the catalyst surface and are held by intermolecular forces. In step three, the hydrogen-hydrogen bond and the carbon-carbon bond are broken, and hence they are attached to the nickel surface. This process of step three is known as chemisorption. In step four, nickel hydrogen bond and nickel carbon bond, which was formed in step three and was known as chemisorption, this bond breaks and carbon hydrogen bond is formed and is repeated to form the ethane molecule. In the fifth step, which is the last step, the ethane molecule is temporarily held by the intermolecular forces, but it will readily break free from the catalyst surface. So this is how ethene gets converted into ethane in the presence of hydrogen and nickel catalyst. This also I have shown you with the diagram on the side. Another reaction I am showing you with lithium aluminium hydride. So this does not normally reduce the alkenes, but alkenes that are conjugated to nitro groups, that is nitro alkenes, they are reduced by lithium aluminium hydride, and in the way as I have shown you. So this is a special reaction for hydrogenation of alkenes. Also, there is heat of hydrogenation which is used to express stability, which I have shown you with one example, that is of cis and trans alkene, and also the their values also I have given you. So this is how the heat of hydrogenation can be seen, that it is more stable, which has the smaller heat of hydrogenation. So this is catalytic hydrogenation.